Tori Henninger, how do you define domestic abuse?
Domestic violence is rooted in power and control. And so what we always have to look at what defines abuse is what is the intention behind the action. If a person is trying to wield power and control over another individual, then it's abusive.
So as the executive director of Barron River Area Safe Space, you have maintained throughout the pandemic, which began in mid-March, you have maintained services 24/7 for the past 7 months and continue to do so. But you've had to make some adaptations there. So talk about external and internal.
Yeah, so I think everyone can agree that everything and nothing has changed. We remain 24/7. We have kept our shelter doors open. We have allowed people access into shelter. We have helped people move into permanent stable housing free from abuse. So everything externally is the same. People can still call us and we will still help. Internally, nothing is the same. Staff have to wear masks and stay 6 feet apart, and we encourage our client populations to wear masks. We have other PPE, we have face guards for people who need that additional protection, or the, full body suits. We try to make sure that PPE is available to the healthcare professionals in hospital systems, but we also are in a communal living environment. And so we do a lot of cleaning every hour and in between uses. So even in our common spaces, which we've had to reduce to just our dining room, with individual tables spread 6 feet apart, we actually had to take two different common spaces to spread out all of our dining room tables to allow people to be able to enjoy meals. But even meals, we provide 3 meals a day and box those up individually. And nothing's the same and everything's the same. We're still here.
Speaking of that, so Barron River Area Safe Space is a 30 bed capacity shelter for family women in particular of domestic abuse. So did you see an increase as the pandemic began? Now, I know you said you saw a little dip in the beginning because people thought services weren't available.
Yeah, when they thought everything closed, they thought that included us. And so back in March, we had a slight dip in our crisis calls. And then by April, we were back to our normal volume of calls. The concerning thing is that while our call volume has been about the same, the intensity of each of those calls has become more significant. The stress and fear related to COVID-19 has increased the abusive incidences that occur within violent abusive homes, as well as, what's happening. So we're seeing, unfortunately, more cases of strangulation, for example. Tempers are higher, and so the explosive incidents are also more intense.
So if you or someone you know is the victim of domestic abuse, COVID or not, BRASS, Barron River Area Safe Space, and other organizations throughout the state are there. So what would you say to someone?
I would encourage you that if you are in a relationship that makes you feel bad, if you are in a relationship where you have to question whether or not you say something, whether or not you do something based off of what the reaction will be, give our crisis line a call. We are here 24/7, 365. We will always be able to answer that call and talk with you about what your situation is and help you safety plan for a safe exit.
Tori Henninger is the executive director of BRASS, Barron River Area Safe Space. And as she says, they're there 24/7. Call their crisis line if you're in need of help. I'm Barbara Deeb, coming to you via Zoom. This is Coffee Near Me. Thanks for joining us. Tori, thanks. Keep up the good work.
Thank you. I appreciate it.